Hello and welcome to TI's Precision Labs, an online video curriculum for engineers. This Precision Lab video will provide a brief explanation of common mode transient immunity relative to digital isolators. This video will answer the following questions. What is CMTI and why is it relevant to digital isolation? How is CMTI measured? And why does CMTI matter for my design? Common mode transient immunity, or CMTI, describes the maximum tolerable rate of rise or fall of the common mode voltage applied between two isolated circuits. For digital isolators, the two isolated circuits in question are internal to the digital isolator and are the transmit and receive sides of the isolator. High CMTI means that the two internal isolated circuits both function within datasheet specifications without errors when the insulation barrier is struck with a very high rise or high fall slew rate transient. This means that the isolator needs to be tested to confirm that the device will operate consistently and reliably under variable fast transient activity. While the CMTI specification is not required to meet digital component standards, it is critical to the performance of your design. This is because low CMTI devices are more susceptible to output errors and signal failures, so selecting a device with high CMTI specification is a good indicator of the reliable performance of the device in your end use case. A simplified CMTI test setup and the typical common mode pulse waveforms are shown here. The input and output signal logic levels are selected to correspond with the datasheet specifications, and a pulse transient, VCM, is applied to the ground on the input side. While the outputs are monitored for a change in logic state, the VCM peak voltage does not exceed the allowed maximum peak transient voltage rating of the isolator, and multiple slew rates are tested. The Digital Isolator Reinforced Standard VDE0884-11 recommends measuring the slew rate of common mode pulse that is calculated from 10% to 90% of the final common mode pulse. Because the output of the digital isolator only supports digital data, a state change due to common mode transients would be considered a CMTI fail, which would mean a change from Vout high to Vout low or Vout low to Vout high under the influence of the transient. In the dynamic form of the CMTI test, both positive and negative common mode transients are applied, while for static test, a logic output high and logic low level input is tied while the common mode transient pulse is applied and the output is monitored for a change in output logic state. The output should maintain its output state within the CMTI specifications, regardless of voltage and temperature. TI's digital isolators are tested for CMTI and provide typical CMTI specifications in the device datasheet. To learn more about CMTI for gate drivers and for an in-depth review of how to test CMTI for isolated gate driver circuits, you can read the TI white paper, Common Mode Transient Immunity for UCC 2122X Isolated Gate Drivers at www.ti.com. This concludes the TI's Precision Lab Introduction to CMTI. Please continue watching to take the quiz. True or false? The CMTI test involves applying a pulse transient across the isolated grounds and monitoring the output of the device for output data errors. The key characteristic of this transient is VCM. False. The CMTI test does involve applying a pulse transient across isolated grounds and monitoring the output of the device for output data errors, but the most critical characteristic of this test is the transient slew rate. How is the CMTI pass or fail determined relative to input transient rating? A digital isolator pass for CMTI means that the output must stay in the correct state. Some fault scenarios that would constitute a CMTI fail include missing pulse, excessive propagation delay, high or low error, or an output data latch. This concludes TI's Precision Lab, What is CMTI for Digital Isolators? You can browse more isolation topics at www.ti.com/isolation.